Hi, and welcome back to the step-by-step guides. And you are with me still, Marius, or have you fallen asleep?
I have not fallen asleep. I'm drinking coffee.
Yes, drinking coffee. And you might need some coffee because we are talking about scripts and deep diving into the app registration parts of Azure or yep. Entra ID related stuff. But in our first step-by-step guide, we were talking about using a graph from PowerShell.
Exactly.
We used something that could be both annoying and then a little bit less secured. We used the secrets.
So the thing is, we used a client secret, right? And that is something that needs to be stored and potentially rolled over because they are usually... have a max lifetime of 2 years. So a better way exists, and that is what we're going to show today in Azure.
Perfect.
So we have in Azure we have managed service identities, and they work essentially like magic. So what we're going to do now is that we're going to create a logic app. We are going to assign it a system assigned identity. We are going to grant that identity some permissions, and then we're going to test whether it works or not. So let's start by creating a logic app. So we go to the Azure Marketplace. We search for logic app and click create. We do consumption based, name it YouTube 2. We have a YouTube 1 as backup if things take a little time. And that is worth noting that, especially towards Entra ID, when creating especially app registrations and new secrets and a few things, it often you need to wait a minute or two before it works. And that... due to some replication and stuff. So just to be aware of that. So now we have created our logic app. So let's just create it as an empty HTTP request app for now and go to the logic app pane here. So under identity, we have two options. Today we're going to use a system assigned identity. And we're going to click on and yes. So what happens now is that Azure will create a new service principal in our tenant. This is the object ID of that service principal, and there will be no secret for that service principal at all. There's no app registration actually for that service principal. Microsoft controls everything, and we simply see the service principal and the object ID. But we can grant that service principal different permissions. So down here you see Azure role assignments. Well, that is fine. So I can easily go in and add role assignments to my Azure subscription, for example. So if I want to use my logic app towards Azure, that is super simple. You can just go to IAM and add permissions. However, on the Entra ID side, it's not actually that simple. There's no GUI for it, which is super annoying. So let's first find our service principal in our tenant here. This is it. As you can see, this was just created. And this value here, object ID, is the same. You can see that managed by Microsoft on certificate expiry status. So we don't handle anything. We can click on it and see some details. For example, we can go to, let's take, permissions. So under here, you can see, well, admin consent, nothing. So there are no permissions. And I don't have the ability to actually add permissions and grant them. So what should I do? I need to read users. Well, your good old friend PowerShell, or actually the Microsoft Graph. is what you're going to do. So let's take this object ID and go into a rather simple script. We're going to replace this object ID on the top and run that line. We're going to need the Microsoft Graph authentication and the Microsoft.graph applications modules. So we'll install those. And then we're going to run connect MG Graph with the two following scopes. It's actually the first one that's important. And the second one, the app role assignment read write all. And this is a permission you should be a bit careful with. So just this is a delegated flow. So I have a user that has this permission. So it's all right. But don't go around and adding this to all kinds of applications, because this can essentially grant all permissions to the Microsoft Graph, including the different consents that give you access as global admin. So yeah. But anyway, let's run it. So we'll have an interactive sign-in like this. Okay. Next, we need to run this special line here, which maybe it looks a bit strange, this 000, but this is a well-known GUID for the Microsoft Graph. So this essentially just gets the Microsoft Graph's service principle in your tenant. So as you can see, this graph variable here now will be a multi-tenant app in your own tenant. Then we can find the app roles. So there's a gazillion of them over here, and we are looking for group read all and user read all. So we're just going to find the first role, which is group read all, and we're going to do an assignment. Then we're going to take user read all, and we're going to do an assignment. So what did I do now? Well, what I actually did is that so all the different application permissions are actually app role assignments on the Microsoft Graph service principle. So that's actually how it works. So what I did is that I found the correct app role for group read all, for example, and then I assign it as an app role assignment. Rather easy.
So this was the part that you were missing in the UI, so you couldn't see it. Yes. In the UI. So,
that is correct. So if we go to permissions here now, we can see that they have actually appeared. Sometimes this takes 3 minutes before they... So we were very lucky.
Yeah.
So we have user read all and group read all. You can see there's still no like admin consent button or anything, but you can see here that it is indeed admin consent that it was granted through. So that's actually how an admin consent works. That's an application that is assigned to the Microsoft Graph app.
And you have to do the same if you are going to remove it. You still also have to remove it from PowerShell or from Graph directly.
Yes, exactly. So we can actually find the Microsoft Graph call Graph Aggregator service here, and under users and groups, we will find all of our different, for example, down here, YouTube 2, there's two assignments. So we can actually see the assignments here as well. So that's just how it works. So now we have a service principle that should have assigned permissions. Should we try to use it?
Yeah.
Let's go to Logic App Designer and let it load. We're going to add a new step, which is an HTTP request. Let's send a get. graph.microsoft.com/v1/users. There's one thing that we need to do to add authentication. We're not going to get a bearer token or anything. We're simply going to go to add parameter, authentication. Then we're going to choose managed identity. We're going to choose system assigned. And then we can type this, which is the audience for that authentication. Click save. Let's see what happens if we run. Run. See, takes a few seconds. There we go. This was apparently successful. And down here we can see our result with users.
Yeah.
So our logic app now authenticated to the Microsoft Graph with, well, we don't handle any client secret or anything at all. And you can do the same thing by going to Key Vaults or working with the Azure Resource Manager API or any other API that is integrated with Entra ID. So this is by far the most secure way to handle these kinds of situations with, for example, a logic app. But this is also supported in Azure Functions, in automation accounts, and a bunch of other services. Essentially, all services that that support these managed service identities, either system assigned or user assigned, works this way. So we can just talk quickly about the user assigned as well. So, for example, right now we have a resource group where we have two different logic apps. So inside here, these two both have, for example, this YouTube 2. This has an identity of 3, 4 AF and so on. While YouTube app 1, we go to identity of that, something else. So they have different enterprise apps or service principles. So, but it is actually possible for them to share. So we could create a user assigned identity like this, user assigned managed identity in our resource group. Let's call it logic apps or something. They can share it. And then we just create it. So this will actually also be a service principle where we don't handle the key or anything, but we simply can do one thing, that is adding federated credentials. Essentially, this will work the same way. So this will also have a, you can see, object ID. And we can now go to our logic apps and we can tell it to, no, don't use a system assigned one. Let's just remove that. Let's instead use this. You can actually have multiple. This logic apps user assigned identity. And now it will be able to sign in as that instead. So you need to tell it which one to use. So there's a few differences, like minor differences, but it works essentially the same way. You can assign the same permissions.
It's still a managed identity, but it's a separate managed identity that's used into it. So,
yes. Yeah. So as you can see here, this will actually, if I do like this, now I can suddenly choose this managed identity and I can choose logic apps. And that was the name of my identity. So I can click save, but right now we didn't add any permissions. So this should fail. It shouldn't have any permission to read the user's endpoint. But if we were to follow the same procedure for that service principle, you see insufficient privileges, which is perfectly what we expected. But if we were to take the same object ID of our user assigned identity, we can assign that the same permissions and it will work just fine.
Yeah, so we have just in the script, we would just change the object ID to the new managed identity that you just created.
Yes, that is correct. And that is everything. So it's not really all that difficult, but it's
much more secure.
Much more secure, super useful, and it's just simpler to manage, right? Because you don't handle the secrets.
Don't expire, right? So that alone is worth the extra little bit of hassle of setting it up. It's just to prevent it from expire. So
absolutely.
Excellent. Well, great. Then we have learned something this time as well.
Yeah, and the script for assigning will be on GitHub, linked in the description of the video.
Perfect. See you in the next episode.
See you.